Hey everyone, this is a LEGO Marvel superhero set called Beware the Vulture. It's based off the Marvel Cinematic Universe and specifically Spider-Man Homecoming. The Vulture himself, fully suited up, looks pretty cool. I thought that it was going to look a little bit silly large, but it seems to scale pretty well. It's compact enough, yet it still has that impressive scale relative to minifigures. It still looks like this whole suit system would be a threat to many of the minifigures. So I think this is pretty well done. It has the two rings in the back for the thrusters. I don't know what they're supposed to be, like lift fans, I guess. However, they don't have any actual fan elements inside of them. I think that's a miss right there. I think that's really important to have something inside of these circles to represent those fast spinning fans that allow the suit to hover. I like the use of so many of those interesting five-sided parts that just fit together to create some interesting shapes here. I really like the feathering at the edges, at the tips of the wings. And this has two stud shooters that are built into the center, which really work properly while you're actually holding the thing. You know, it's very convenient to hold this from the back and then operate the two of those. Also, they can be removed and used with the figure alone. And I especially appreciate the ability to get it to stand up like this. You know, they don't include any clear stand to make this stand up higher off the ground, but just the fact that you can get it like this in a display form, I think is pretty important. You can also kind of flap the wings. So I've got the wings back just a little bit here. You can bring them straight forward and you can bring them, I thought it was just one, it looks like a couple of ratchets forward. As for moving them back farther than that, things start to get in the way with these elements on the back that provide the connections again for the lift fans, if you will. Really nice stickers on the back there. That is quite nice. Too bad they're clear backed, so you see some bubbles showing through. I tried to burnish some of that down, but you have to be careful nowadays. With those clear backed ones, they'll actually bring adhesive over the edge as you try to burnish them down, which then just smears everything up. But really nice print designs there. I'm usually not that huge of a fan of just the quality of stickers on normal things, but this is pretty well done. And of course, you know, all these appendages at the ends can be changed around to create some relatively dramatic poses. Overall, I just think that this is done right for LEGO scale. This truck is built 8 studs wide, plus a little bit because of the extension of the fenders and also the wheels and tires. The wheels and tires actually come from Speed Champions, but I feel that for this scale, for this size, it's actually built fairly compact. There's not a lot of overhang on it. There's not a lot of unused space. I like how much curvature there is along the sides of the thing. The only thing that I don't like here in terms of its proportions is definitely the choice of tires from Speed Champions, because they're just very, very low in profile. I feel like a truck like this needed something that was higher in profile, a little bit closer to off-road or just general, you know, all-season use. This looks like it's trying to be like a racy type of vehicle. I like the stickers on it, especially the one on the back. Most of them are just showing Spider-Man webs and various amounts of damage around it. The yellow showing through is fine. I think it's supposed to represent either the kind of interface between a camper shell and the base truck, or it's just being a stripe going through. But it looks just a little bit awkward there with the exposed hinges, but I like this action here of being able to open up the roof and then pull out this 6-stud shooter. You know, by default, that's a pretty big thing to have hidden away just normally. So being able to get that out, being able to access it easily and quickly with no trouble is good. You can fire from the back if you want to. Folds back away pretty easily. And also around the back, they have a ramp that can be brought down. And there are a couple of things you can do with that. And that can be used for loading and offloading. Move this out of the way. Got some cargo in there that can be brought out. Now, one of these is empty and one of them is not. They have two different stickers that you apply to the tops of them. And the one that has something in it is this here. They call it the Tech Egg. I haven't seen the movie yet. I don't know the lore that they're going with, but that's supposed to represent the tech egg. It's just two pieces, you know, very simple for the minifig scale there. But the other thing you can do with the ramp is tear it off completely. I thought this was a cool idea. Tear the ramp off, and I think that this will have a direct connection to the movie itself, something that will happen in the movie. You do have to kind of reset the clips, because most of the time those clips actually do pull off like they just did, but put the Spider-Man web on the back of it, and you can just see this as kind of the aftermath of him, you know, Spidey coming up and webbing up the back of this thing, causing it to stop, you know, just connecting it to the ground and basically trapping it into place, or at least putting a lot of drag on the base of it. Nice little, you know, small thing that you can do for changing up your scenario based on what time that you're looking at this chase here. There are a couple of clips inside of the side panels, and they have some small items in there. There's this thing, and then over here, there's this thing, two pieces each, but the idea is that you would put the two together to create a minifig launcher weapon. Actually, better yet, do it like that. There we go. And that's a weapon that can now be used. The driving compartment is nothing special. They don't have actual opening doors on the sides or anything, and it just fits a single minifigure centered right there, but they have enough room for the gauntlet pieces for the Shocker. We'll look at the figure up close very soon. They've done something cool for Spidey in this set, introducing the Power Blast piece previously used by Iron Man in Trans Light Blue. Now it's molded in white to actually give you the small web blasts to come from Spidey himself. They give you a couple extras of these in the set, and I think that these work great. I think that they are one of the more successful action features that LEGO has introduced, because they look kind of cool just posed if you're not going to do anything with them, but they also work quite well. They fire nice and straight. They're much larger than studs, so they don't get lost easily. Off that goes. I think it's a good thing. The Spider-Man figure there on the left looks great to me. To me personally, to my eyes, it looks like one of the better Spider-Man figures ever made, if not the best. Good printing on the side of the arms, dual molded legs, fine details in the torso, a good expression for the face, if you will. And then, speak of the devil, there's Iron Man with yet another one of his suits. I've given up on keeping track of them. They're just making way too many of those things, so I'll just defer to the experts on that. But then the Vulture is a pretty important figure in this set, obviously, and he's got a really good print for his torso as well. No print for the hips or the legs, but the torso, I feel, makes up for it. His helmet is based on the mold of the classic Iron Man style helmet that LEGO did, and I think that it fits just fine. They did a good job with the print. It wraps around the sides enough to really change the overall look of it, to make it not look like just a reskinned Iron Man helmet to my eyes. I think they changed it enough, and you know, the color helps with that as well. Shocker gets good crosshatch printing for the arms, and they give him the pair of gauntlets, which are a little bit comically large from LEGO, but I think it was a good choice to include those. They could have just done like metallic silver colored hands. I think that would have worked okay as well, because you know, the gauntlets aren't that huge, but like I said, I think this works for LEGO. His print for his torso is actually pretty nicely detailed as well. Again, nothing coming down to the hips or the legs. Take a look at these from the backs. Yep, more good stuff. The Vulture gets connected to his main flight suit via the bracket piece there. Let me take that off. Oh, snap. Forget about the Vulture for a second. What does that mean? There's no print on that head. What in the heck? Is that some sort of spoiler that means that it's actually going to be a Jarvis that is in full control of the new suit? There's no Tony Stark inside of it? Holy heck. Yeah, that's awkward to say the least, but interesting. We'll see how that actually ends up factoring in, but I do want you to see what that looks like with the helmet up like that. Okay, it's unfortunate that you see the little white mark inside of there, but this lets you see the Vulture's regular face, and you also saw the print on the back of the torso and the back of his head, of which there isn't much. I'm surprised that they didn't give a mask or a helmet of some sort to the Shocker, because what we've seen so far, as of the time of the recording of this video for him in the movie, he has a mask on. So yeah, I don't know what's up with that. Maybe he'll take the mask off pretty quickly and spend most of the movie without it, or maybe, I don't know, maybe Lego's a little bit out of sync with that, or they weren't able to find a good solution for a nice thin mask. They could have just printed it onto the head. I don't know. Let me know what you think about that. There's how he looks holding onto that small built-up weapon. And I also wanted to point out that Iron Man also, or at least the Iron Man suit, also comes with a couple of blasts for foot thrusters. So a very intriguing set, has some interesting features, some interesting parts and prints, and raises some interesting questions that will not be answered until the movie comes out. I think that overall, the Lego designer has done a very successful job of incorporating play features for kids into this, having things that are nice for collectors. The suit here, the Vulture suit, actually looks good on display. The truck looks pretty good, but the integration of the opening sides does bring in the kind of line there through the waistline of it in the back. It doesn't look so great, and I don't think that's a good choice of wheels and tires there. A little bit of modification will make that look much nicer. So I will leave it at that. If you'd like to add anything based on your own knowledge from this universe, please feel free to leave a comment down below. Also, let me know what you think about the set. What are your favorite aspects of it, or what is your favorite thing here? What don't you like? As always, thanks much for stopping by. And if you'd like to, stop by again soon, because my next video is on the way.